Fifi joins us again on the show. Has Daisy changed her mind now that you've read it to her?
No, I haven't read it to her. Oh, she won't let me read it to her.
Wow.
Neither of them have read it. Not a great endorsement for my new book.
I'll say, Fifi, I'm putting one of my acknowledgements in my Frankie Fish books. First kid to read this gets a free ice cream, one of my kids. They still haven't mentioned it. That was 5 years ago. Yeah.
God, you didn't give it long before you did a plug for your own book.
Yeah. Well, that's an old book. That's still in stores.
Have you got Carrie's review yet? Because that's
brutal. I got emotional when I actually just read it for the first time before the show, and it is a beautiful book. It's heartwarming, and it is, yeah, it made me quite
teary. Don't suck up now, Carrie.
No, because it's all about, you know, non-traditional families, and it was beautiful about a little girl who felt she was all alone because she didn't have the traditional family. Anyway.
Well, that's great. I mean, I was going to ask Fifi what it was about, but you just...
Did she nail it? Was there anything she missed?
She really did. You nailed that. Thank you.
She skipped over to the trifle page.
Yeah, I know.
Well, you dedicated your book to your daughters. You wrote, "To my beautiful girls, Daisy and Trixie, family comes in all shapes and sizes and don't always have the same parts, but it's not important how many people are in your family, rather how much love is in your home. Aww. And our home is overflowing with love." Is this Is this idea of sort of that non-traditional family something that you talk to your kids a lot about?
Well, it was when I was having Daisy particularly, because I had her through IVF by myself, I knew that was an issue I'd have to deal with at some time. But then when I thought about it broader, all kids have different incarnations of families. So, you know, some kids are only children, some have one mum, some have no grandparents. And I thought, you know what, every kid is missing something and probably looking over thinking, I want a family like theirs. So for me, look, it's a fun book. It is actually fun. It's rhyming. And for me, I've got to write something that I enjoy reading for parents. But, yeah, these kids find out at the end of the book that they're not missing anything. And really, for me, even with my kids, I try to teach them gratitude for what you've got. Stop looking out at what you want. Mm. So that's really the message, that whatever your family looks like, whatever shape it comes in, your family loves you.
I heard, don't look elsewhere. Trixie, your daughter, talking to my daughter, Evie, in the back of the car about, because they're talking about Daisy and how she came into the world. And it was the most fascinating conversation hearing kids talk about just that. And they're having a conversation about, like, families and what makes family. I thought it is a conversation that this generation of kids will be having. And they had it in such a beautiful way that didn't come with any, like, judgment or anything. It was just so real and raw. Mm. And I think this kind of book can start those conversations for many families that feel that they're, like, alone.
Yeah, and I thought that because in our situation there's no dad. But then, you know, I grew up wanting a sister and I still want a sister. I didn't get one. So I just think it's so broad. And I've got friends who don't have, their kids don't have grandparents. So I just thought it's actually universal. Not everybody has every piece of the puzzle, and we should tell kids it's okay.
Aww. You two are obviously great mates, and you caught up at the Radio Awards recently.
Yes.
Carrie told me she had a pretty quiet night.
Lies. But lies.
I did see a picture of you guys giving each other a hug. Now, is this a hug or are you in a headlock? Is that a headlock or a hug?
That was at the start of the evening, so I don't know what you were talking about.
Why are you looking at the camera there, Carrie? You look like a villain.
I can be a tad aggressive when
hugging people. That man's about to come and sort that out.
Yeah, because I think we also have the two...
Our youngest. Yeah. You can see where they get it from.
You can see where you get it from.
This is my daughter trying to hug Fifi's daughter. Yeah.
This is a very similar vibe going on. Oh, yeah.
Addie's always way more into
away,
it.
That.
Yeah, yeah, it goes on. Addie's always the one.
He doesn't know how to get out.
That is actually exactly what happened in your photo.
It's true.
That is uncanny.
Yeah, I think I'll say about you two, you both look fab tonight. It hasn't always been the way, has it?
Because
there was a time when you both looked drab. And I only say that because I read it in a magazine. And I think we have the magazine here.
Do we? Oh, please. Drab.
Now, Carrie, you posted this, so this is...
To be fair, we weren't even friends then.
No.
We had no idea that those drab ladies would become besties. I think we looked fat back then as well.
This
is a different era.
I really went a little too hard with the curly one.
Isn't it great when they wheel those photos out of you and, like, remember this?
Yeah,
like, just let me evolve, would you? Let me evolve.
Cool. Well, Posy Pearl is a Curious Girl is out now. It is an absolutely beautiful book. It's always a pleasure. Thanks, Fee.
Always a pleasure. Thanks, guys.